लीगल न्यूज 16 जुलाई टू 22 जुलाई 2017 बाय दीपक मिगलानी। मिनीष पटेल ए गुजरात रोइट कन्विक्ट गेट्स बेल टू फाइंड ग्रूम फॉर किन। डायरेक्शंस टू डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोर्ट टू इंश्योर स्पीडी जस्टिस बाय दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट। जीएसटी काउंसिल हाइक्स सेस ऑन सिगरेट्स। दुबई बेस्ड वुमेन हेल्ड इन अगस्ता केस। व्हाट्सएप फॉरवर्ड इज नॉट एविडेंस दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट। दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट नोटिस ऑन फ्री सैनिटरी पैड्स। फ्रेश प्ली बाय अबू सलेम टू मैरी ए वुमेन। यू आर ट्रीटिंग आवर ऑर्डर्स विद डिसडेन सुप्रीम कोर्ट टू सेंटर गवर्नमेंट। सेटअप पैनल टू मॉनिटर मेडिकल एजुकेशन सुप्रीम कोर्ट टू सेंटर गवर्नमेंट। गुजरात हाई कोर्ट रेफ्यूजेज टू स्टे रुपीज 45,000 करोड़ एसआर स्टील इंसॉल्वेंसी केस। एनजीटी नोटिस ऑन मिलेनियम बस डिपो। लाहौर हाई कोर्ट लिफ्ट्स बैन ऑन इंडियन टैली प्लेस। फ्रेम स्कीम टू प्रमोट विडो रिमैरिज सुप्रीम कोर्ट। राइट टू प्राइवेसी नॉट एब्सोल्यूट स्टेट कैन प्लेस लिमिट्स सुप्रीम कोर्ट। आधार मे बी मेड मस्ट फॉर ई कोर्सेज यूनिवर्सिटी ग्रांट्स कमीशन। आप गवर्नमेंट फाइंड फॉर नॉट रिप्लाइंग टू हाई कोर्ट नोटिस। दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट सीक्स स्टेटस रिपोर्ट इन सुनंदा डेथ केस। पिटीशन इन सुप्रीम कोर्ट फॉर कैंसलेशन ऑफ प्रज्ञा सिंह ठाकुर बेल। रुपीज 50 फाइन फॉर यूरिनेटिंग इन पब्लिक इन साउथ दिल्ली। आर यू पेइंग लाइसेंस फी हाई कोर्ट आस्क्स ली मेरिडियन। जाकिर एनजीओ मूव्स दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट अगेंस्ट बैन। सुप्रीम कोर्ट आस्क्स सीबीआई टू फाइल चार्जशीट इन ऑल व्यापम केसेस बाय अक्टूबर 31st। नाउ न्यूज इन डिटेल। मिनीष पटेल ए गुजरात रोइट कन्विक्ट गेट्स बेल टू फाइंड ग्रूम फॉर किन। ए 2002 रोइट्स कन्विक्ट हैज गोट बेल फ्रॉम द गुजरात हाई कोर्ट टू कंडक्ट इंटरव्यूज ऑफ सुटेबल बॉयज वू हैव बीन शॉर्टलिस्टेड एज पोटेंशियल मैचेस फॉर हिज डॉटर्स एंगेजमेंट। मिनीष पटेल ए कन्विक्ट ऑफ द ओडी मसार्क ऑफ मालव भोगोल वेयर 3 पर्सन्स वर किल्ड was sentenced to life imprisonment along with others by a special court in 2012. The court had found him guilty of murder, conspiracy, rioting and arson. Patel first sought bail last month on the ground that he had to arrange the admission of his son in a diploma course. The High Court ordered his release for 15 days. Patel urged the court to extend his bail period for 30 more days to meet potential matches for his daughter. A bench of Justice Abhilasha Kumari and Justice A.J. Shastri granted 7 more days to Patel after taking into consideration his good conduct in jail. Directions to district courts to ensure speedy justice by Delhi High Court. To ensure speedy justice and better utilization of limited resources, the Delhi High Court has directed district courts to allocate work as per a judicial officer's expertise, dispose of cases within realistic timelines, and not give more than 3 adjournments. The directions were issued by the acting Chief Justice Geeta Mittal to ensure proper implementation of Civil Procedure Code provisions related to adjournments, timelines, as well as electronic filing of cases and service of summons. GST Council hikes cess on cigarettes. The GST Council increased the cess on cigarettes by a range of 48 to 79 paisa per stick, aiming to check the windfall being reaped by the manufacturers after GST. It's not clear if cigarette prices will rise following the move. The government maintained the decision will have no impact on prices. Dubai-based women held in Agusta case. The Enforcement Directorate has arrested Dubai resident Shivani Saxena in connection with the Agusta Westland helicopter scam in what is being seen as a breakthrough in the efforts to identify the recipients of kickbacks. Shivani, wife of Rajiv Shamsher Bahadur Saxena and a resident of Palm Jumeirah, Dubai, has been accused of laundering the proceeds of crime in connection with the bribes received in the VVIP helicopter deal. She had been called here for questioning. WhatsApp forward is not evidence. Delhi High Court. Any document shared on WhatsApp does not qualify as evidence unless the original is produced, the Delhi High Court said. Justice Sanjeev Sachdev made this observation while hearing a petition which sought directions to three states, including Arunachal Pradesh, their police and CBI for registering an FIR in connection with an alleged suicide note of former Chief Minister Kaliko Pul. Pul was found dead at CM's official residence in Itanagar on August 9 last year. The court inquired with the petitioners about their source of information. The petitioners, National Lawyers Campaign for Judicial Transparency and others said they had obtained the information from a WhatsApp post. Delhi High Court notice on free sanitary pads. The Delhi High Court issued a notice to center and state government on APIL seeking directions to educate adolescent girls about menstrual hygiene and providing free sanitary napkins. A bench comprising Acting Justice Geeta Mittal and Justice C. Harishankar also asked for a status report from the center, Delhi government and civic bodies by November 7. Fresh plea by Abu Salem to marry a woman. A month after the special Tada court held him guilty of being party to the conspiracy behind the March 12, 1993 Mumbai bomb blast that killed 257 and left 713 injured, Abu Salem had sought permission to visit a marriage registrar office to solemnize his wedding was with a woman from Mumbra near Mumbai. Salem had first moved the marriage permission plea in August 2015. His application then had followed the woman's plea before the Tada judge for permission to marry him. Her plea was that rumors of marriage with the gangster in 2014 had made it difficult for her to find a match and left her defamed as her name and photographs had appeared in media linking her to Salem. You are treating our orders with disdain, Supreme Court to Center Government. The Supreme Court severely criticized the Union Government for treating court orders with disdain while pointing out that Center had taken no action on its order on 19 September last year seeking guidelines on disaster management to make schools safer. A petition by Avinash Mehrotra had resulted in the Supreme Court issuing several orders on safety of school children after the Dabwali fire incident in Haryana and Kumbakonam tragedy in Tamil Nadu, both involving death of many school children. Set up panel to monitor medical education, Supreme Court to Center Government. The Supreme Court directed the center to form a panel of eminent persons to take over the function of the Oversight Committee headed by former Chief Justice of India R.M. Lodha for regulation of medical education and profession in the country. Although the Medical Council of India is the apex body to regulate medical education, the apex court had in May last year appointed the Oversight Committee saying Medical Council of India had been unprofessional in discharging its duties properly. As the Justice Lodha Committee completed its one-year tenure, a five-judge bench headed by Chief Justice J.S. Kehar asked the center to appoint a panel to replace the committee. Gujarat High Court refuses to stay rupees 45,000 crore Essar Steel insolvency case. The Gujarat High Court refused to stay insolvency proceedings against Essar Steel initiated by banks led by State Bank of India following a directive from Reserve Bank of India. The debt-laden steelmaker had sought to stay proceedings on the ground that RBI should not have given such a direction given that restructuring proposal from SR was not considered. Justice S. G. Shah of Gujarat High Court said that it is clear that when the total debt is more than rupees 45,000 crore, there is no option but to leave the issue at the discretion of the lenders to take appropriate steps in accordance with the law, thereby without interference of this court under the constitutional mandate. NGT notice on Millennium Bus Depot. The National Green Tribunal sought responses from the AAP government and the Delhi Development Authority on a plea filed by an environment activist seeking shifting of Millennium Bus Depot as it is located on Yamuna floodplains. The Green Panel issued notices to Delhi government, DDA and Delhi Transport Corporation seeking their replies before 24th July, the next date of hearing. Lahore High Court lifts ban on Indian tally plays. The Lahore High Court has lifted a 9-month ban by the country's media watchdog on airing of Indian tally plays, terming it null and void. The Pakistan Electronic Media Regulatory Authority, an independent body that regulates the content of print and electronic media, had imposed a blanket ban on all Indian content on October 19, 2016. Granting permission to private Pakistani channels to telecast Indian teleplays, Chief Justice Mansoor Ali Shah said the ban was unlawful as the federal government had no objections to Indian content being telecast in Pakistan. Frame scheme to promote widow remarriage, Supreme Court. Expressing concern over the plight of widows who are forced to live a life of destitute after being abandoned by family members, the Supreme Court asked the center to frame schemes to promote their remarriage and bring them into mainstream society. A bench of justices Madan B. Lokur and Deepak Gupta said, although the government had framed many schemes over the years for rehabilitation of widows, several of them continued to live a miserable life after being dumped by their families in places like Vrindavan. It said the center must take steps to remove the social stigma attached to widowhood and also rehabilitate them by imparting skills so that they could lead an independent life. Right to privacy, not absolute, state can place limits, Supreme Court. The Supreme Court expressed strong reservations about declaring right to privacy a fundamental right, said privacy could never be an absolute entitlement with the state having no power to restrict it. You all are arguing as if right to privacy should be declared as an absolute right. What should be its width and contour? What should be the reasonable restrictions attached to it? Right to privacy cannot be so absolute and overarching that the state is prohibited from legislating restrictions on it. A 9-judge bench told petitioners who argued for privacy to be treated as fundamental right. The bench, comprising Chief Justice of India Kehar, Justice J. Chelameshwar, S. A. Bobde, R. K. Agrawal, R. F. Nariman, A. M. Sapre, D.Y. Chandrachud, Sanjay Kishan Kaul, S. Abdul Nazir, will continue the hearing as the center is yet to put forward its arguments. Aadhaar may be made must for e-courses, University Grants Commission. Aadhaar may be made mandatory for pursuing all online courses and only those universities which have been in existence for at least 5 years allowed to offer such courses according to the draft UGC rules. AAP government fined for not replying to High Court notice. The AAP government has been slapped with a fine of ₹5,000 by the Delhi High Court for failing to respond to a notice on a radio cab operator's plea alleging levy of excess road tax. The cab operator Magic Seva has claimed in its plea that road tax being demanded from it was in excess of what was permitted under the law and more than what was being collected from regular taxis. While imposing the cost, Justice A.K. Chawla directed the Delhi government's transport department to file its affidavit within 2 weeks. Delhi High Court seeks status report in Sunanda death case. The Delhi High Court directed the Delhi police to file a status report in connection with an ongoing probe into the death of Sunanda Pushkar, late wife of Congress MP Shashi Tharoor. A bench of Justice G. S. Sistani and Justice Chandra Shekhar directed police to place on record within 3 days its report on a plea filed by BJP leader Subramaniam Swamy seeking a court-monitored CBI-headed SIT investigation into the matter. Petition in Supreme Court for cancellation of Pragya Singh Thakur's bail. A petition has been filed in the Supreme Court seeking the cancellation of Pragya Singh Thakur's bail in a case pertaining to the Malegaon blast in which 6 people were killed in 2008. She was granted bail by the Bombay High Court. The petition filed by Malegaon resident Nisar Ahmed Bilal alleges that High Court had erred in concluding that there was no prima facie evidence against Thakur. Rupees 50 fine for urinating in public in South Delhi. South Delhi Municipal Corporation has issued a circular saying that anyone found urinating in public will be fined. Are you paying license fee? High Court asks Lee Meridian. The Delhi High Court asked Lee Meridian Hotel if it was paying license fee in accordance with the court's earlier order. The High Court was hearing a plea on New Delhi Municipal Council's plan to ask the hotel to vacate the premises. Appearing on the behalf of the civic agency, Additional Solicitor General Sanjay Jain informed Justice Sunil Goad that NDMC has already begun the eviction proceedings against the hotel and urged the court to allow it. Jakir NGO moves Delhi High Court against ban. A bench of Delhi High Court's acting Chief Justice Geeta Mittal recused itself from hearing a plea by absconding Islamic preacher Jakir Naik's NGO Islamic Research Foundation to set aside the Special Judicial Tribunal's decision to ban the organization under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. When the plea came up for hearing, Justice Mittal excused oneself from a case because of a potential conflict of interest or lack of impartiality herself and directed that the case be listed before another High Court bench. Justice Geeta Mittal questioned whether the High Court has the jurisdiction to hear the case or whether the appeal should have gone directly to the Supreme Court. The hearing will now continue before a different bench on 27th July. Supreme Court asks CBI to file charge sheet in all Vyapam cases by October 31st. The Supreme Court set October 31st as deadline for CBI to file charge sheet in all pending Vyapam scam cases and ordered it to submit the forensic test report of the seized hard disk and pen drive before the trial court along with the charge sheet. Thank you.